is the difference between your AQI and local AQIs? How can you compare the difference between the two AQI values?
Okay, so I think first of all, I need to explain what is air quality index, AQI, for those of you who are not familiar. Air quality index is the way the different governments communicate air quality. So the average Joe does not know what 200 ppb means, right? And in order to translate this to a language where everyone can understand, we take concentrations, or the different governments take concentrations and translate them to an index. And this index can vary. So for example, in the US, it goes from 0 to 500. And in Hong Kong, it goes from 1 to 10. And it can vary from one country to another. There are many, many different air quality indexes. And for each number, there is a category associated with it that relates to health. So there is good and moderate and hazardous. And all of this is based on epidemiological studies that the different governments decided to use for to build their air quality index. What's the problem with that? The problem is that the different each country has a different way to do that, right? So the thresholds are different, and some of them are ascending, so, and some of them are descending. So for example, in the US, 500 is hazardous, it's bad air quality, while others have high numbers as being good air quality. And I would like to know how the air quality in New York is compared to Beijing, right? And there is no easy way to do that. If you don't compare concentrations, you cannot really do that. But the air quality index is very different in China and in the US.
Like speaking two different languages.
Exactly. And so that's the reason we decided in BreezoMeter to make a global air quality index. And you can just, right now, if you want, to look at, you can look at our heat map and see the air quality at your location and compare it to another place, New Zealand compared to Germany, or China compared to whatever you like. And you can see it very easily. Our index goes from 0 to 100, 0 being poor, 100 being excellent, where the logic is that percentage, where I got 100%, I got 100 in my exam, and so that's for us, it's good air quality. The other limitation with using air quality index for the different for different countries, and the reason we created our own index, is the fact that the air quality index is mainly meant for regulatory purposes, as I mentioned before. And if I take particulate matter particles of a size 2.5 microns, PM2.5, for the US EPA AQI, you can see that the air quality index is based on a 24-hour average. And that makes sense for regulatory purposes. However, we see that people, customers, and businesses we work with, they want to know the air quality here and now, and not 24-hour average. And so our index is hourly based. And I'll give you an example. Why is it important? Because, again, if there is an event like fire and it just started, our index would show it. And if you take a 24-hour average, that would not show the fire so well, right? Because it will do an average of high concentration with, let's say, good air quality, and which will be maybe moderate. So that's the difference.